Back. This is Mohammed Badrudja, and today we are gonna exploit the horizontal privilege escalation vulnerability in access control module lab number 9, and we will do that with manually, and we will also write our custom exploit with Python. Okay, so as we all know that I'm covering the series of Web Security Academy from PortSwigger, and here is warning for you guys that this video and its content are only for educational purpose and I do not support any unethical or illegal act. So let's go to the lab. So because I don't want the video very lengthy, okay. So this is the lab. Here I already put everything. So user ID controlled by request parameter with data leakage in redirect. Okay, so it means there should be some redirection. When we make some request, it will redirect the page, and while redirecting the page, it will leak some value. So that vulnerability is also known as information disclosure. Okay, so this lab contains an access control vulnerability where sensitive information is leaked in the body of the redirect response. Fine. To solve the lab, obtain the API key for the user Carlos and submit it as the solution. Fine. And we have the credentials here. Okay. So let's go to the lab and we see what we have. I already open up the burp suite, and I need to change this port because I'm using 8080 port for other service. So I make it 8088. Fine. Okay, so this is the lab. I will go to the page source. Okay, all these are the blogs. Nothing interesting we have here. So we will directly go to the login because we have the credentials. So login, sorry, Wiener and Peter. And I also want to mention one thing, that these videos are not edited or not scripted. Whatever I do it on the same time because I don't have so much time to give to YouTube videos. So I want to capture all the requests on the burp suite, and I want to turn this off so that silently capture my all the request. Login, don't save. Fine. Okay, so here we got the API key for the user Wiener. Same like this, we will have the Carlos key, but first we need to check what request we have. So login. Okay, in the login we have username, password, and also there is one more parameter, that is CSRF token, cross-site request forgery. And this takes us to the my account, and this is the response for my account. And we can see that this my account link is actually have a path. So let's go and try to access this path. So when we click this, our URL will get changed, and it's include one path, ID is equal to Wiener. So I want to make it Carlos, and let's see what happened. Okay, so it redirects our page to the login because we do not have authorization on the Carlos user resources, right? So it checks whether my session allotted for the Carlos user or other user, and if not Carlos user, it will redirect our request to this. Fine. Or maybe some other kind of authorization in the backend is scripted. So now what we need to do, we need to inspect this request, right? This is our request, and here you can see the response is 302 found. 302 means redirection. This status code belongs to redirection. But what in previous labs, what we see when it's redirect, it does not normally give us the response code, right? The response source. But here we have. So let's see, because it is a bit abnormal. So yeah, and we got the Carlos key. So username is Carlos, and this is the API key. So to solve the lab, I will just copy this key, and you need to submit here. Okay, but right now I am not doing this because I will write some script to automate the whole process, log in and change the URL, go to the response and retrieve the API key for the Carlos user, right? So disable here the bug suit and let's go to the script, right? So we will start it from here, and what we will do first of all, lang slash user bin, and I am going to use Python 3. Okay, other thing, as you all know, we need to import the modules. So request, and the second one would be sys, and the third one would be urllib3. Okay, next I want to send all this traffic. First of all, I just want to save this on the desktop, and lab09.py. So it brings some color for us. Okay, so I want to send all this traffic through the burp proxy. So proxy is equal to this, and I'm using HTTP proxy, http://, and my loopback address 8088 port, and for HTTPS also I will use http://12:8088, right? Sorry. The next thing is to create the main function, and need to specify the argument. So if name is equal to main, okay, main this, fine. Now we need to define the main function. So def main this colon. Okay, so now what we need to check whether the user once he is going to execute the program or a script, first check whether he is passing the argument or not and defining the argument here. So if length of sys.argv is not equal to 2, so what it should do, it should print, okay. So I'm gonna print message for the user, so he will know that how to execute this command. Example percentage www.test.com, and is no give space sys dot argv and 0. Okay, next is time to exit this -1. Okay, the next thing is we need to specify the argument, and the argument will be url is equal to sys dot and 1, fine. And next thing is we need to specify the because I divided this whole process into three parts. The first part is we need to, as we can see here, in the login request, we have one more parameter, that is CSRF, that is auto-generated token at the time of login. Okay, so to login, we not only need winner and password as username and password, we also need this token. So the first part of this script is to retrieve the CSRF token. Okay, so let's do this. Get login. Okay, and argument would be URL. Okay, so save it and let's go create the first function first one. Okay, colon. So what, before jumping into this, I want to do one more thing. I want to introduce one more thing. We need to, because all this process, first take the CSRF token, retrieve the CSRF token, then login, and then go to find the Carlos user API key. All this process will be connected with one session, right? So what I'm going to do, I'm defining here a session, so that session is equal to this is belongs to the request module. So requests request dot session. Okay, so now everything will come into the session and we will send any request, whether it is get or post, belongs to this session. So the session ID will be same. Fine. So let's go first get login, and in the get login I'm going to create request, because I'm going with the session. So session dot get and URL equal to URL comma verify is equal to false, as I mentioned before that I don't want to check the SSL validation, and the next thing is proxy, because I want to pass all these requests through the proxy. Fine. The next thing is to capture the response as res r.text. Okay, and print this response, save. Let's go and run this. So because this we save in the desktop, so come to the desktop, Python 3 lab, not 8, I think we save it as lab 09, where we save this. Okay, in the root folder in the home directory, so we need to come here /root. Clear. First of all, I want to check whether it is validating the URL or not. So lab 9, with if we do not pass the URL here, what it will do, it said okay. I think the same mistake I did in the last one. Good. So now it's telling us that we need to put the name of the script, and then we have to pass the URL, right? So now what we will do, we will pass the URL. So this is our URL /login, paste it here. Okay, and we got the response. Now one thing you need to point out here, that this CSRF field is hidden. Okay, the CSRF field is hidden. That's why we are not seeing this on the login page, but its value is auto-generated and it's already mentioned here. So we need to retrieve this value from this response, right? And another thing is the URL we put here is with slash login. If you do not put slash login, so what it will do? Let's see. Okay, so it will give us the response will be the home page, and in the home page there is no input field for the username and password, and not also for the CSRF hidden field. So that's why we will not get the CSRF value if we do not mention slash login. So we must mention slash login here. Okay, so let's make it clear. I hope you understand what I was trying to tell you. Fine, so we get the response, means we are working fine up to here. Now what we need to capture is CSRF value. So for this we will use from BS4 import one more module, its name is beautiful soap. Okay, and now we would say soap is equal to beautiful soap, and inside the first argument will be response, and we want to parse it into HTML. So parser, html.parser. Okay, now we need to find out the CSRF value. So CSRF is equal to soap.find. okay, and this time the actually the soap value, if we go into the page source, this CSRF value is inside the input tag before we retrieve the value of hrefs from the a tag. But here this time we will extract this value for the CSRF from the input tag, right? So fine, and here we need to mention input. Okay, second thing is name. Okay, from the tag is input, name is, name of the field is CSRF. So name is equal to name, and because we are putting it in the dictionary form, these curly braces for the dictionary. So in the dictionary the format is like this. Okay, the key for the dictionary and its value. So key is name and the value is CSRF. Okay, and we want to retrieve its value, this value. So you must take care of this when you are retrieving the value. These values must be same. Okay, CSRF means CSRF, name is name, and value is value. So value. Okay, now let's print CSRF, save, and let's see whether we get the CSRF token or not. So slash login, if no slash login you will not get the value. So let's test first if we don't make this. See, object is not subscriptable. Clear. Now this time I will put login, and here, yeah, we got the CSRF value. Fine, now we have username, password and CSRF value. Now we can login. Fine, so also we need to do something for this warning. So I will go here and I would say url3.disable_warnings. I am confused. Let's see if we got warning or not. Fine, we did not get warning. So okay, I want to show a message to a user, and the message would be CSRF token is this, and then we want to return its value. So return CSRF, save. The first part is completed, okay, and here we can say CSRF is equal to get, because in next part we need two arguments, URL and also CSRF. Okay, so the next method we will define is post login, and here we need two arguments, URL and CSRF. Okay, fine, save it. And let's make this one def post underscore login, and the first argument will be URL and second one is CSRF. Okay. So to post the request, there are certain things we need to mention, because in the post request we have to pass the data, okay, for the post request. So as you can see in the burp request, this would be the data. Okay, so first of all we need to create the data. So data would be it's the variable value, you can name as you want. Okay, you can name it as you want. So it would be in the curly braces because it's in the dictionary form. So, and another thing I want to mention, these values must be same as here. If suppose that instead of username, if it put only user, so you have to mention only user, right? If instead of password, if it say, for example, value is equal to Peter, so you must put the value. Okay, so I copy it, and the simple way to do this is there, but we need to put curly, and I don't want this value because we already extract this colon. Instead of equal to, we need to mention colon and CSRF, because we already have CSRF here. Okay, and I don't want this, actually I don't like. Another thing is parameter username, and its value, we have the username Wiener. Okay, another parameter is password, so we have the password and that is Peter. Okay, because these are the manual value I am putting, and it's a string, and this CSRF that we already have here, its value, so no need for this, is not itself contain the value. Okay, next thing, now we can go for the request. So R is equal to from the session dot post this time, and URL is equal to URL, comma data is equal to data. Okay, and verify is equal to false. Okay, and also one more thing I want to mention here, when you make login, when you post this request, you can see the response is redirect 302, response is redirect, and when it redirect, then it takes you to the user page, user account page. If the redirect is not allowed, then you will always stay here and you cannot go forward to my account page, right? So here we must allow the redirects equal to true. Okay, if we make it false, then the response stay on the 302 and it will not redirect you to the next page. Okay, so request is done. Let's take its response in res. Fine, and let's print its print that clear login return CSRF. What we messed up, soap.found. Soap.find input, okay, name CSRF, value is value, and return RETURN, baby. Yes, fine. Now that's okay. So, okay, so first of all, this is the CSRF value, and as I told you, it's always whenever you log in, it will give you the auto-generated CSRF token. And if we are logging successfully, then you know the page, the looks for the winner user. So if I go back, so there must be username is equal to value and API key. So let's see, here it is. It means we login successfully. Good. The second part is also approximately completed. What I need to do, I must say if, because I'm WIE, I think WIE, yeah, WIE in your wiener. If wiener in response, okay, print, because how we will know that we are logged in, because in the response page we will find wiener user. So if wiener is in the response, then I will show the message. Login successfully. Okay. So the second part is also completed. Now the third part is there. So for the third part, what we need to do now, we need to alter the path, this path, and put it Carlos here. Okay, and in the response we will try to extract the API key for the Carlos user. So here what I will do, post, then I would say print extracting Carlos API key, save, and then I will define one more function here, get API key, and it will need URL. Okay, but the problem here that the URL gets changed here, not the same URL you are supplying passing with the command. No, because now we need to put this URL. So I will put this URL manually. So I copy it and go here, def get underscore API underscore key, and it needs URL colon, I will say URL2 is equal to this, but here instead of wiener I will say Carlos. Okay, and let's go do this. This time we need a get request, so r is equal to, and from the session.get, and URL, this is very, very simple. once you do this 1, 2, 3 time, and you will know each and everything what you need to do. Very simple. And because we are not supplying the post request, so no need for data. Verify is equal to false. Okay. And allow redirect. Okay. Is equal to true. Fine. And one more thing, I make one mistake here. I want to send all this data from the proxy, also from the proxy. Oops. Yep, that seems good. Okay, same thing I'm doing, just a bit logic has changed, so you can do this. Very simple. Now what I say, I will check if Carlos in response. Okay, so print, we got this. Now what is the logic and what we are actually doing? When we put here user instead of Wiener, we put Carlos, and we send the request. This one. Okay, so what it does, it redirects us to the login page, but before redirecting, actually, okay, in that page it give a response, and in the response, while redirecting in the response, it provides us the information belongs to Carlos user. Where is it? Yeah, here. So, and one more thing in my mind, that I think this true is not gonna work, because when we make allow redirect, so what it will happen, it will not stay on that page, and it will not take that response here in the rest, and it will go to the login page, and it will put only the response source as the login page. So in that way we will not, I think I am not going to get the Carlos user. Let's try this, because we must stop that redirection. Okay, let's do this. We get the CSRF. See, extracting Carlos key means we are on this, and it said, yeah, same, allow redirect. Okay, so first of all we made a mistake, it's allow redirects. Let's do again. Yeah, so what we say here, in the response, if Carlos is there, then print this. So if it is not finding the Carlos, and that's why it's not printing anything, so we must put this one false, and we must stop this request to be redirect, then we will get catch the Carlos user. So after making false, let's see. Yeah, so it means Carlos user is there now. Okay, we approximately reach to our destination. We just now need to extract the key, filter the response, and bring the key, right? So for this I am going to use regex or beautiful soap, both, because first of all I will okay, so soap not here, is equal to beautiful soap, and I really like this. It's really beautiful because it gives you a lot of capability to do things with the response. Okay, and HTML dot parser and API is equal to soap dot find. Okay, so what we need to find, let's see. Because this API key value is in the div tag, so we need to capture this with the div tag, right? So, or we can do one more thing. Not so. Okay, let's do this with the regex. I will do this with the regex. You can also do this with beautiful soap, but I think this is gonna be very easy with the regex because I'm comfortable with it this time only. Otherwise, beautiful soap can also get the value for us. So re.search. Okay, and what I wanna search, because I wanna show you something. Beautiful soap, you already retrieve value from the a tags and from the span in last lab, so I want to show you in a different way. So I will go to the pythex, as I mentioned this one also in the last lab. Here what I will do, come here and I will copy all this response, copy including the API key. There is API key, this is the, this part has the API key. Okay, and what I want to mention here, I want to say I will capture from here to here. So it would be like key is, so the green part is what we are capturing. So key is and dot match any value, then star. Okay, so it captures the value up to here, but we don't want this one. So I can say come up to this. So it is still go up to here. No, it should come up to here. So the greedy thing come here. So for the, to avoid this, you can see this one, non-greedy. So I apply this and you can see now it comes up to here. Now what I want to do, I want to capture only this key, not other things. So I will put one. You must check this part, match capture, okay, because the value will come here. So match one, and we got the API key, right? Fine. So now we need to take this, go here, and in the quotes you put this value. Fine, and the second argument is soap. From the soap, we because all the response in the form of HTML parser in the soap. So from the soap, I retrieve this value. Okay, so let's print. Plus Carlos API key is and so API, yeah, API. And as I mentioned before, that this thing, this part is gonna divide the whole string into two parts, because when you come here you can see it's capturing, filtering the data from here to here, but we don't need this. So when we put these brackets, it will divide this string into two part. One is up to here and the second one is up to here. Okay, so and into two groups. So the first group is group 0 and the second group is group 1. So group 0 means this value and group 2 means this value, and we put the question mark so that it will not greed, not it will not search as greedy, so non greedy, it will ignore this. So we will have only this value. Okay, so this one divide the whole string into two parts. So I want to take the second part, group, and because it counts the value from 0, so 0 will be the first value and 1 will be the second value. So I want second value means 1. Okay, and done, fine. Okay, so let's save this and go here. Okay, and we got this error. So it's saying the type error expected is string or byte like object, because in Python 3 you must specify the data type, otherwise it will keep giving you the same error. So the value inside the soup is a string. Okay, so now let's see whether we get the yeah, we got this, and this is the API key. So just copy this and come here and submit solution, paste here, and you are good to go. Where is it? Is it working? Yeah, we solved the lab. It takes a bit time. Fine. So we done our job. Okay. One more time. Back to the, no. We already saved that, so it's not showing that. So let me know what, and you can verify it from here. The last request we sent this, and no. Go to the login. This is the CSRF value. Come here, you can match. This is the CSRF value, and go to there, and you can match the Carlos 7DBA, and last is V3GDH. So 7DBA, V3GDH. Okay, thank you very much. If you like this content, please like, subscribe, and share. Support me so that I can record good videos. Thank you very much. See you. Bye-bye.